Thank you. presenting the graduates of the College of Human Ecology. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology, for mid-year 2019, Nathan Joshua D. Aguilar, Jasmine Angela Y. Kapati, Mary Cel T. Noai, cum laude, recipient of CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence. For the first semester 2019-2020, Adrian B. Afalya, Romilly Ann E. Apostol, Arantia Alex L. Carpio, Janelle C. Cielo, Marielle Cyrene A. Collado, Junlin May P. Evangelista, Jessa May C. Feria, Rhea Jude A. Ferrer, Francesca Carolyn Yagman, Ayan Sandwich M. Medina, Angelica M. Sarmiento, Darlene A. Tandam, Chiara Gabriela M. Villanueva, Elaine Jane T. Macalino, cum laude, recipient of CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence. Marie Bernadette C. Apayor, magna cum laude, recipient of CHE Faculty Medal for Academic Excellence. For the second semester 2019-2020, Althea Gabriel B. Angeles, Kiara Aleli Arlegi, Angelica Jean O. Artates, Lovely P. Vanzuela, Michia P. Bernardes, Katrina Bismonte, Diane Rose C. Bueno, Maria Abigail Jean B. Cabazan, Maya Salve Jennifer I. Kalubayan, Jillian A. Canoy, Kasmir M. Capuno, Marco Gabriel C. Castillo, Claire Marley M. Gaviola, Zelika N. Gonzalez, Navy Gladys G. Herradura, Aliana P. Maneja, Camille F. Mangrobang, Dana Marie O. Mercado, Nailin Joyce B. Milante, Jenny N. Ortilla, Gladys Pearl D. Parnicio, Kisha C. Pineda, Mariano Joshua C. Ramirez, Lorenzo Diar Raimundo, Alaisa Joyce V. Saguin, Jana B. Santos, Ann Pauline S.B. Siababa, Jalzain Anjanette D.C. Vasquez, Dane Mikael L. Villegas, Carmela Grace R. Yeso, Joyce D.C. Estacio, cum laude, recipient of CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence. Dube Kiana M. Mayor, cum laude, recipient of CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence. Melissa Roylin M. Remorca, cum laude, recipient of CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Nutrition, first semester 2019-2020, Jewel Claudine N. Baclay, Jean Bernadette E. Bagayan, Lori Cristel T. De Leon, Juan Jesus Davide F. De Ocampo, Sarah Marie A. Don, Jonah Camille M. Lepaño, Diana Angelica G. Gonzalez, Patrine Reya S. Moreno, Lisa Lorraine M. Moreno, Eloise Dainis S.J. Pantaleon, Gillian Angelo S. Cinco, for the second semester 2019-2020, Carla L. Abiog, King Philip B. Alcantara, Sherry Lynn M. Alcon, Marco Nico O. Aquino, Patricia Muriel G. Aquino, Hermenegildo P. Arciga III, Denise Ann M. Banaira, Mark Spencer K. Barcena, Shekina Ginel C. Benecito, Marie Antoinette S. Bernabe, Rachel May V. Kabigan, Faye Marie G. Kahapay, Aleya Marie A. Capistrano, Deborah Angelique D.C. Capulong, Agape Joy M. Caro, John Madeline A. Carpio, Raquel John M. Cordero, Christine Jewel C. Damian, Ranzel M. De Los Santos, Aileen D.R. Domingo, Genrev A. Esguera, Camille Bianca Y. Estillore, Jairus Ernie A. Evasco, Kate Charmaine S. Ferreira, Iris C. Gastardo, Johanna Cariz L. Gonzalez, Catherine M. Iranzo, Kate B. Lacuata, Janela Aisla A. Lastrella, Anne Kirsten G. Lomibaw, Johanna Patricia B. Manalad, Maria Franrey S. Manalo, Jose Marie M. Mangaban, Jana Alexia M. Nesio, Jana Clarice D.R. Ocampo, Julia Camille G. Orial, Malaya V. Pallier, Maria Kathleen Joy V. Pandato, Joyce Marie P. Pantorilla, Patricia Isabella A. Patiga, Justin Mave V. Posa, Shanna Faye P. Rada, Kate C. Reyes, Vermonica A. Satuito, Robert Jake Daniel M. Tan, Jamelia Jean P. Victa, Queenie Kyle G. Waperiqua, Gabriel Mayben C. De Guzman, cum laude, recipient of the CHE Dean's Medal for Academic Excellence.
A pleasant morning to everyone, and to the UPLB class of 2020, let us congratulate ourselves for hurdling every difficulty that we encountered in our journey towards graduation. Let us not just applaud our fellow students who are graduating with Latin honors, but also those who did not wait for their formal graduation to assume their responsibility as members of our society. Let us be thankful to our fellow students who are selfless and brave enough to go out on the streets and be the voice of the voiceless while minding their academic requirements. These questions made me realize that my worth as a person and my ability to make a change in our nation are not inversely related to the number of years I took to finish my degree program. 5 long years of perseverance, diligence, and yes, moments of doubt. But finally, here I am with my sablay. This is not to encourage academic delinquency, but to remind people that things could still get out of hand even if you exerted so much effort to avoid such unfortunate circumstances. However, let us be mindful that there is always another chance to find a way back to our goals, and that is if we just keep on reminding ourselves that we have a definite purpose to fulfill despite the delays and the setbacks. I also hope that people will stop being judgmental to delayed students and invalidating their efforts. Let us constantly be reminded that we are not actually aware of what they had to go through just to attend every class or to submit every class requirement. And to you, my fellow graduates, let us remember that each of us has a story worth sharing, because it is not just our academic feats that make our stories and college life valuable, but rather the lessons that went with them. I therefore encourage everyone to let your stories be heard. Let your stories spark hope in our nation during these trying times. Let your stories inspire other UP students who are still fighting for their eventual graduation. Let your stories help in building a dream of a 10-year-old elementary student in your community. Let your stories encourage incoming and current college students to broaden the purpose of their professional dreams, from just earning a decent income for their families to also serving our nation. Aside from inspiring people, I also believe that our stories are meant to open eyes. I am well aware that with us are graduates who struggled financially while finishing their degree programs because of the multitude of academic requirements that they had to spend their tight allowances on. Some of us may even have friends, former classmates, or relatives who opted to stop attending college because of the lack of financial resources. Let us then amplify these stories to serve as a wake-up call to those officials sitting inside their air-conditioned government offices that quality education remains a privilege for some instead of being a right for everyone. Some of us may also belong to communities where out-of-school children and out-of-school youths are common. Let us echo the stories of these people to call for an inclusive education system. And now, that the new normal for students necessitates having stable internet connection and electronic devices, it is expected that more students will be deprived access to quality education. Parati nating naririnig na kabataan ang pag-asa ng bayan. Pero paano ito mangyayari kung hahayaan nating manatili ang isang sistemang patuloy na pumapatay sa pag-asa nilang makapag-aral? Let us continue calling for a sustainable change in our education system. Let us strive for a new normal in which no students are left behind because our country is investing more on ensuring equal access to quality education. Right now, we are all enraged with the incompetence of this government in addressing the pressing issues in our country. This should make us more eager to fulfill our duty as a scholar ng bayan para sa bayan, while remembering the reasons why we desire to make a positive impact in our nation. I hope the values that the university instilled in our hearts will be our armor against corruption and will be our guide to always side with what is just and right. One of us can be the next leader of this country, but still fail to serve the people because of the lack of compassion and the wrong inclination of the heart. I believe that it takes a radical change in our hearts to continually serve the people without losing hope. And it starts by being compassionate and empathetic of the situation of our fellow Filipinos, especially the underprivileged and the oppressed. From this should stem our personal decision to translate our compassion and empathy into actions that would really lead to the solutions that we desire for our country. With this, I hope that every personal dream that we will make as we go out of the university will always be tied to our aspiration of improving the welfare of those in the marginalized sector and of the betterment of the Filipino nation in general. Nawa ay laging nasa Diyos at bayan ang ating katapatan. Padayon, mga eskolar ng bayan para sa bayan.
Tapat akong sumusumpa bilang isang nakapagtapos sa Universidad ng Pilipinas. Nasisikapin kong maging karapat-dapat sa karangalan at pamantayan at kahusayan ng aking universidad, na isasaloob ang mga bagay na mag-aangat sa aking kaisipan at pagkatao at mamamalaging nasa panig ng batas, kalayaan at katarungan, alang-alang lahat sa paglilingkod sa bayan at sangkatauhan.
Mangyari lamang na tumayo ang mga magtatapos at itaas ang kanang kamay. Taos puso akong nanunumpa na isa sa katuparan ko ng buong husay, katapatan at walang pag-iimbot ang mga tungkuling nakaatang sa akin bilang kasapi ng samahan ng mga nagsipagtapos sa Universidad ng Pilipinas. Ipagtatanggol ko at ipaglalaban ang kapakanan ng universidad na aking pinagtapusan, ang Universidad ng Pilipinas. At ipinapangako ko magiging matapat na nagtapos sa universidad na ito sa lahat ng pagkakataon. Kaya tulungan nawa ako ng Diyos.
Pakitaas po lamang ang ating kanang kamay at sumunod po kayo sa akin. Taos puso akong nanunumpa na isa sa katuparan ko ng buong husay at katapatan at walang pag-iimbot ang mga tungkuling nakaatang sa akin. Bilang kasapi ng samahan ng mga nagtapos sa Universidad ng Pilipinas, Los Baños, ipagtatanggol ko at ipaglalaban ang kapakanan ng universidad na aking pinagtapusan. At ipinangangako kong magiging matapat na kasapi ng samahan na ito sa lahat ng pagkakataon, kaya tulungan nawa ako ng Diyos.